According to our next two guests, there are distinct differences in how men and women think about sex. We've heard this before,
yes.
I think. Especially when trying to conceive, and here to address common myths and realities that will help couples arrive at a better understanding in the bedroom are Dr. Paul Turek and Dr. Ricky Polykov. Welcome back, both of you.
Thank you.
This is called the Adam and Eve segment, you said, right?
Yes, I'm Adam.
And I'm Eve.
There we go. Okay. Well, let's eat from the tree of life.
Let's do it.
Okay. What are the main differences in between men and women in our views of sex?
Well, of course, the main difference is that women are going to have the babies ultimately, and so we have this incredible menstrual cycle thing that prepares us for this magical event called ovulation. And the good news is that that's when we're actually more interested in sex and we're more fertile.
You mean naturally or knowing that it's ovulation time?
Well, naturally, okay. Actually, if we're rested and not so distracted by our work, that might just happen without paying attention to the clock.
Wow, okay. And what your take on it?
So the problem with that, too, is that women, are, when they're more fertile, want sex. It's sort of a natural thing. A lot of species have that. And men, although they know what to do and they like to do it regularly, aren't very good at scheduled sex.
Right.
So it's not a constant appetite that men have, usually. It's
contrary to popular belief.
Right.
Right.
You'd think it'd be constant. A lot of women think it's... But actually, if you tell a man that between 3 and 5 o'clock he needs to have sex because his wife's... He will, you know, lots of times have performance anxiety or have other issues because that's not the nervous system that's going on at that point.
Right.
So what are you supposed to do? You have that window. And you want to get pregnant, and it's time to go. It's go time.
Well, the main thing is...
And
let's make it fun. You know, like the food segment. I mean, let's get some diversity in our recipes and spice it up. Okay. You know, we go to restaurants, we buy cookbooks to get good ideas for the kitchen. So what about the bedroom?
So how do you suggest that a woman spice it up when it's her window of opportunity and the guy may not necessarily, you don't want to put the pressure on him, like perform now.
Exactly.
Well, one thing to realize is that when you're trying to conceive, that stuff lasts for several days in there. Yeah. So it's not like...
Okay.
5 o'clock is essential.
Okay.
I mean, it could
it's
be 8 o'clock.
It's not like the scallops in that fry pan.
Right, exactly.
Right, okay.
You've got some lead
time. That's good to know.
And you can say, come on, honey, you know, I'm better in the morning.
Yeah.
You know, or something like that. So I think that's one quick point.
In fact, 9 out of 10 men prefer to make love in the morning, whereas 9 out of 10 women prefer to make love at night. So that's a little bit of a performance contrast.
I was just going to say, morning has always been one of my favorite times. along with afternoon and evening.
And it's because men's testosterone. Janelle.
I'm listening.
Hey.
Men's testosterone levels are highest in the morning,
exactly.
So it's very...
So are women's, actually, but it's not that big a difference.
Right.
Okay. So what if there are problems conceiving? When should you actually seek a specialist?
Well, if women are over 35, we're not that patient. You know, if you haven't gotten pregnant in 6 months of trying and you're more than 35, you really should see a fertility specialist.
Okay.
If you're younger, our outside limit is basically a year, and a year of trying without taking birth control pills or using a barrier method of contraception.
Right.
Yes,
right.
Of course.
So timing it is a luxury. So there's unprotected sex and there's timed intercourse. Most couples don't know much about timing intercourse. They know there's sort of a period. But unprotected sex would qualify. A year of that would qualify.
Okay.
Needing it. And I would say, you know, if the woman generally takes the lead with the gynecologist, the man should be seen as well. That would be my statement about that.
Right. Okay, because with a urologist or something?
Yes, a specialist.
Okay.
Male specialist.
So aren't there the fertility specialists, that's like one person to see the man and the woman, right? Or is it mostly
for
the man?
Well, in the United States, we usually divide it up.
Okay.
Although most fertility specialists who are gynecologists and specialty trained in fertility also do preliminary evaluations with men, and then when we're stymied, then we send the men to Dr. Turek for a urologic consultation.
Okay.
So, but I think it's important to talk about how do you juice it up in this critical time. I think what tips do you have?
Right. Yeah,
okay.
What tips do you have?
Yes. Okay, well, the main tip is to make it fun. And so we need to diversify and often lubricants that smell nice, a little massage oil or some lotion. You know, women love flowers. We love the visuals. We love candles. It may not be, you know, putting on some porn video, whereas some men, you know, they like that.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
so exactly. What do men want?
I would say to men more of, you know, they're sort of geared to go, but I would say kill the cell phone, you know, get the laptop out of the bedroom, lock the door,
no
TV, no telephone, nothing. And if you have kids, babysitter, lock the door.
Yeah.
Okay. And, you know, and let it sort of, let that sort of sensitive little small flower bloom.
Yeah, right. I like the fact that we can have fun with what is a serious subject, because the longer a couple is trying to conceive without success, I would imagine that the more the fun level diminishes.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah. Stress
and the anxiety goes sure. up.
Yeah.
Right,
yeah.
Right. And especially, I think, in our culture right now, many, many women have kind of delayed childbearing to the outside of the fertility interval, mm-hmm. and we really haven't focused on that. You know, we've been more focused for so many years of not getting pregnant. And so it's sort of funny to say, but it doesn't necessarily come naturally. And that's why it's very helpful to bring it out in the open and talk about it and communicate.
We do have a puritanical view of sex in America. It's, you know, based on our religions and things like that. We don't have a lot of free play in there, and we don't give a lot of thought to it like we do with cooking. I mean, it's you know, this is our nightcap here. We just have the meal, we smell it. And, you know.
Free play, not to be confused with foreplay. It's a
That's
different,
right.
but they
yes.
go together.
Absolutely.
Yes. Okay. Thank you. So our two favorite doctors. Great to have your advice. Check out their advice on our website. And we'll see you tomorrow.
Bye. Okay.